Venture Minerals. This morning's Andrew Radonjic. Andrew, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you?
Very good, Andrew. Positive updates out this week on your South West Nickel-Copper project. You say Chalice have identified these new EM anomalies. Give us a bit more detail.
Yeah, that's correct, Andrew. Yes, our joint venture partners had some, if you like, early success in delineating some new EM anomalies with a ground program they're doing at the moment. So I suppose the exciting part about that has been that one of these anomalies, one of the stronger ones that they hit, is adjacent to some of our old drilling.
So a suspicion here that the anomalies have some similar characteristics to Julimar.
Well, look, certainly the geology is right. We're getting in that hole that we drilled back in late 2018, had some quite anomalous platinum and palladium results in there. So, you know, having an EM plate, which should represent sulfides, and certainly history suggests that at Thor, you know, we could be up to something quite exciting.
So the EM program itself, Andrew, you're only a third of the way through, are you?
Well, that's right. They started relatively late in the season, and in the southwest corner of Western Australia, winter set in, if you like, and it becomes quite cost ineffective to continue. So the decision has been to sort of stall the program and recommence in spring, and that'll the remaining two thirds will be completed, but. You know, really, at the moment, this third that we've done now has only just started getting into the exciting zone. So I think the best is still to come.
Might it be a little optimistic to hope for some drilling this year if you're not going to finish this program till, say, end of November?
Yeah, that's correct. I would suggest that they'll need time to assess the targets, and a joint venture needs to spend $1.2 million by the end of July next year. So clearly, the first part's been delayed till November. So to do drilling will certainly be happening in, I'd suggest, the first half of 2022.
But clearly, this is a cracking start to the EM program. You must be thrilled.
Oh, look, we're very excited, and conductor next to a hole that's already intersected 86 metres of disseminated sulfides, elevated platinum palladium, I'd be dead keen to drill now myself, but of course it's in the hands of our joint venture partners, and there may be better targets to come. So who knows, this might be the second, third, fourth, fifth ranked target compared to others, which is pretty exciting.
And Andrew, just while I've got you this morning, any news from Riley? How are things there?
Look, the commissioning's quite advanced now. You know, we've been going through the process, and we've recommenced mining. We're putting material through the plant and generating a product. And once we sort of hit a sort of steady state, we'll look to start haulage shortly.
And that first shipment, Andrew, what are your expectations?
Well, look, once haulage starts, we'll probably need around about a few weeks of trucking. So stay tuned for a bit of an update. So once that happens, we'll inform the market, and then that first shipment will follow around about 3 or 4 weeks afterwards. It'll take to truck that, circa 40,000 tonnes to the Port of Burnie.
Very good. Andrew, thanks for your time.
Yeah, pleasure as always. See you later. Bye.